Hello, Mr. Arniger, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. In the previous video, I was telling that Professor Keith Ward, an eminent professor in theology of the Oxford University, could not explain why the conscience of the people differ from one to the other. And as I explained in my previous video, that our conscience is governed by our mind, our past deeds. Not all, everybody is the same. Some are cheat and some are vicious and some are gentle, you know, they are very soft spoken and they do not want to hurt anybody. So these are differing conscience is due to the fact, you know, that when you are born, it is a rebirth, reincarnation. So when you are born into this world, we don't know what previous birth you had. This previous birth is only known to the people who have the very spirit of God, such as the apostles. They could tell you, but they don't tell, because this will be more confusing people and other thing. But in India, you know, these Sache Pasha, Harraiji and other, when they used to go hunting and other thing, and they found one snake, you know, basking, and they told their Sikhs, you know, who were accompanying them, that this snake used to be in previous birth a pandit, a rabbi. So for cheating people, he has taken this birth. All these births that you come across is according to your past deeds. If you have performed good deeds in the past, they are carried forward to your next birth. And the carrier of this one is your mind, which we call man. So we have the soul is when you do something, you do it with your full knowledge, then your mind is the one which is letting you to do it. And mind is blind. So when you are born, natural man, your mind is blind. It is by the grace of our Father that your mind is awakened, which we call twice born. So when you become twice born, then the thing you do, if you do things wrong knowingly, then that is a sin. Or in Jesus, it is blasphemy. So if you have been doing things wrong, unknowingly, that nobody has told you the right thing. Remember in John 9, the blind man whose eyes Jesus opened, in that one Jesus said it to them, that now you know what is right and what is wrong, and now if you do something wrong, that is a sin. So people, you know, they do, when their mind is blind, they do things wrong. Unknowingly, it is not their intention, but they have not been given the common sense, or their mind is not awakened to recognize what is good or what is bad. Same thing, you know, Saul, he had learnt this letters or scriptures from a well-known teacher, Gamaliel. Gamaliel himself, he was honest person, but he was blind to spirit. That means he has sold himself to these the praises of people, to the temple priest. So he earned his praises when he was reading or when he was teaching the scriptures, as these university professors, you see them when they teach the theology in universities and colleges, which is our letters, you see them, they are very proud, you know. And they don't know whether they are doing right thing or wrong thing, but they, and in their heart, they feel, you know, they are doing the right thing. Same thing was Gamaliel and other people were doing, but in spirit they were dead. They were earning the praises of men. These university professors, they have their praises of men, not of God. In God, you know, as I call, you know, they are like donkeys carrying holy books. So they don't understand gospel. So they only understand the letters and what the other people have, dead people have written. They carry down their dead traditions. They never sit down and think, you know, ponder over his word, or ponder if what they are doing is right or wrong. So that is what we are, have the difference. We who are not, have been to theological colleges or universities, we are different from them, that we have not been brainwashed. So if we listen to something, we ponder over it and we test it or vet it in spirit. And if it's right, then we take it, otherwise we reject it. So I was giving the example of Saul. Saul being a Roman, he was not one of the people of Judah tribe or any of the chosen people. Those chosen people, they were very much proud of their, hey, our Torah, you know, our temple, you know, this and that, you know. They were very proud of their Torah. So they only know the letters. When they had studied the letter, memorized them, they were feeling very proud, as the university professors are today. When they memorize the history and other things, they are very proud. When you ask them simple question, they have no answer, because then it's not written there. For example, I asked the professor of church history, how you build the temple of God on rock and how you build it on sand. What is that? And he had no knowledge, because he had not read it in any books. The books haven't told them. If the books, it had been written in the book, you know, then he would have given me the answer. But it wasn't. So he hadn't read it, so he could not ponder over it. So a common man, when he's told the gospel truth, he accepts it very quickly, without any hitch. But the university professors and other people who are drunk with the old wine of the letters, to give them a new idea or to tell them something new, which is not written in their books, they haven't read, you know, they are very reluctant to accept it. So this Professor Keith, when I told him, you know, that this the natural laws, which they apply to the natural person, or our physical body, to natural self, or to the nature, which we can see with the two naked eye. The things of the God we cannot see, but we perceive. The God is spirit, and he is not bound by any law. He is free man. So we receive the knowledge of our Father by his grace. If he doesn't want us to know, we won't know it. So when he let us have his grace, then we understand his word. Then we know our Father. These university professors, they being drunk with the old wine of the letters, they are not suitable to receive grace. But still, Father has mercy, as he had on Saul, whose conscience was good. So he came to know about God, and he was given the very spirit of God. Same the university professors over here, they are good people.